Hi everyone, my name is David Rousseau. I will be the professor for this course called Phenomics. We will be talking about methods of phenotyping based on imaging with a focus on dedicated image processing techniques, and we will be using an open source software called Phiji. I'm a full professor at University of Angers, and I'm happy to give you this course. In this video, I will give the motivation of why phenomics is important and try to give you insight of what you will learn, but also what you will have to do as work in this course and how you will be evaluated for this work. So why do we need a phenomics? You are of course aware that humanity is experiencing new climate scenario. Unfortunately, mistakes from the past will have consequences in the future, like evolution of the global warming at the surface of the planet. And while all humanity is trying to reduce the emission of CO2, we also have to prepare for the already scheduled consequences in terms of climate scenario by, for instance, selecting crops that will be able to cope with the consequences of this climate scenario evolution. So as scientists, what can we do to help in this unseen and completely new to everyone, to every humankind on the planet? What we can do is select new crop varieties that could be able to resist to drought, to floods, to high temperature, to rising sea levels, or to storms, in order to not prevent the global warming, but reduce its consequences on the food resources for the humankind. So there is an issue to do this, is that this process is very long and takes something like 10 years. It is at the moment done with non-objective procedures, with visual inspection and manual measurement, and it results in non-uniform criteria and legislation between countries, which are maybe different from one to another, so that it's difficult to share knowledge from countries from the south to the north, and so on. So phenomics could come to the rescue by speeding up annotation with autonomous devices, producing objective measurement via standardized sensors, and also resulting in the possibility of a shared knowledge and shared legislation on variety selection. So at the moment, such a European project has been launched 2 years ago, and I'm leading one of the work package, the one specially dedicated to plant phenotyping. And I will be happy to share some of my expertise with you via this course. The objective of the course is to learn basics of imaging and image processing for plant phenotyping. And at the end of the course, you will know which imaging modality are used in plant phenotyping, but also you will know how to select important parameters in the choice of sensors and illumination. You'll be able to design automatic image processing pipeline for basic problems that you will apply on various types of enzymes. The organization of the course will be the following. So there are four chapters, one dedicated to plant phenotyping, a short one. Another one dedicated to sensor illumination, how to pick up a good sensor and adapt the illumination to have a good contrast. Then chapter 3 will be the core of the course on image processing, and then we will have hands-on and exercise. We will care about a balance between course and hands-on, which is a 50-50 balance, but of course we will start with more course, and as we progress in the course, we will have more and more in the teaching, we will have more and more hands-on. I'm aware that these 20 hours are very condensed in a single week, so I know you will have to invest a lot of energy in a small span of time, but we'll try to do our best for you to learn the basics of this phenomics and being able to use this knowledge in your scientific career later. So the schedule is announced here: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So 4 hours every day. However, I know it will not be possible to stay in front of the screen for these 4 hours with just listening to me. So the remote organization will be the following. The course itself will be to visualize on already recorded videos, and then we will have more discussion via Zoom at the end of the session. So for instance, on Monday, we have teaching on this phenomics course from 2 o'clock to 6 o'clock, Mech time. And then we will have, at the end of this session, a Zoom discussion for from 4:30 to 6 o'clock. So from 4:30 to 6 o'clock. Same on Tuesday and Wednesday. And on Thursday and Friday, we will have full online session of hands-on for the 4 hours. So this is the organization that I propose to you for this week. All the links to the videos will be sent to you via via emails, and of course all the slides and paper to read will be available on your usual intranet. So you'll be assigned tasks and obligations. So for instance, solution of hands-on will have to be provided by you for Monday, the 1st of February. You can work in a duo. We will define this duo together at the end of the first course, and you will have to upload on this folder your work for the this date. As responsibilities and obligation, a written test will also be scheduled by the institution. I don't have the exact time at the moment. The final rate will be 50-50 of these two works, and the tests of the last 2 years are already available on the intranet. We will have a look at them to together to give elements of response, and also for you to be aware of what we expect from you in this test already from the beginning. Articles will are provided to read after each course, so students will be questioned about their understanding of this reading during the Zoom session. So you will see by in my email, you will have some of article to read, and I will question some of you on what you understood of this, and we will discuss about the content via question and answers during this Zoom session. So that's it for this video. I hope you will enjoy the course despite the conditions. I would like to be with you in the nice Mech Institute, and I hope we can, however, via this remote organization, connect together, and I will be, of course, fully available to answer your question during the session, but also after, and even for after your life in a Mech, if you have questions or requests on these topics of phenomics, I will be happy to exchange with you via my academic email that you are you can see here. See you on Monday for the beginning of the course, and I will be happy to meet you.